Hi, I'm Christian, and welcome to the second episode of the second season of ctrlX developer. As you know, at least if you watched the last episode, this season is all about what you can do with the ctrlX core and how you can make use of all of its power. But now, let's turn to our today's guest, Kai Müller. The viewers who have seen the first season should still remember you. Together we unboxed the ctrlX core and we showed what makes it so revolutionary.
And for those of you who don't know me yet, I'm Kai Müller, and at Bosch Rexroth, I'm working in the technical sales support department as a ctrlX automation expert for PLC and motion.
And also for IT networks and security.
Yeah, that's right. And that's why today I'm going to show you how to set up and program a ctrlX core for our handling application you configured in the last episode. User-friendly, clear, and without complex tools.
Sounds great. If you haven't seen the first episode of this season, you can find the link in the description below. Kai, can you give us a short summary what makes programming the PLC and setting up the ctrlX core so special?
Sure. To describe it in one sentence, it's the user-friendliness, the app-based system with standard interfaces, and the web-based configuration.
And you even don't need a physical controller to get started.
Exactly. This works completely in a virtual environment and ends up in a human-readable file in JSON format. I will show you this in a moment, as well as PLC programming, but everything in a nutshell.
Because the detailed commissioning of our Cartesian robot for pick-and-place applications, which we're setting up during this season, is explained in the associated how-to video. You can find the link to this video in the description below as well.
Right.
But let's go back to the virtual environment. That means I can practically pre-commission the control and prepare everything at my desk, even without having the ctrlX core or the rest of the automation system right in front of me.
Right, even if you haven't ordered it yet. And once the system is ready, it's almost like plug and play. You take the JSON configuration file and put it on the system. And what's more, you can test run the system completely dry without any accessing controller.
Sounds like a dream come true.
Yes, absolutely. And this saves an enormous amount of resources. And the JSON format allows you to change parameters directly in the file.
Sounds great. Can you show us something?
Sure, let's start the configuration together. If the ctrlX core virtual is already started, we can access it here directly through the ctrlX works, or we can simply open the browser and enter the default IP address that we see here.
Ah, and here we are already on the landing page.
That's right, and this is where we can now directly load our apps, which we need for commissioning. We simply load them from our local PC via the local storage tab.
And for today's application, we need the motion app and the PLC app.
Right, and the additional apps we need in the future, we'll just add them later. Now let's install the apps and switch to operation mode to make them work.
And then we can create our own configuration.
Right. This is what we do here via configurations. We just created a new project. How should we name it?
How about developer?
Not very creative, but okay. So let's start. Below, we can already see our two installed apps. And in the motion app, we can now create our three axes for the handling application. Name it axis X. Axis Y and axis Z. And after that, we set up the kinematic.
In our case, it's a Cartesian robot.
Yes. And the robot, we assign our axis now. And now we create our PLC program.
And this is done via the automation area.
Or directly via the PLC tab. We have a dialog box here where we can choose whether our code will be stored on the PC and which core we want to connect. In addition, here we can select if it should be synchronized.
And they should.
Right. Next, we can choose here if we want to start from scratch or use a template. For example, we provide a very easy to use kinematic interface.
Okay, and there we have already some access and a kinematic.
Exactly. Here you can see our access. And here you can see our kinematic. However, I already prepared the complete code based on one of our templates. You don't need to take care about the access state machine. Our interface will handle it for you. Just select the operating mode.
And we have already finished our PLC program.
It's actually not that fast then.
But almost.
Yes. After the PLC program is running and tested, we just have to take care about the EtherCAT and connect the real access with the access in the motion app. And if you are interested in the whole PLC programming and EtherCAT configuration, you can check out the how-to video.
And how easy is it now to transfer it to a real ctrlX core?
As mentioned in the beginning, you can transfer the whole setup in one archive. You can find the access configuration here under Configurations. In the corresponding folder directly as a JSON file.
And there's even a preview of the JSON file.
Yes, and as you can see, these are human-readable configuration files.
Means you're completely free in creating them, maybe with the help of a PC program, and then upload them to the configuration.
Correct, you can change the configuration data very easily.
For instance, a machine builder can automatically generate a machine configuration in JSON format by using the ERP software, download it directly to the control, and you're all set.
Correct, I see, you understood the concept. By the way, we still have in the Motion app the commissioning area for access and kinematics, where we can move and test the access directly in the machine, even without a PLC program.
What exactly can you do here?
You can, for example, set a position, speed and dynamics here and check them directly via execute.
That's it? It's so easy to set up a robot.
Yes, it is that simple. The detailed setup with all the steps can be found in the how-to video, but basically that's it. We're looking forward for your questions and comments and hope you have fun with PLC programming on ctrlX Core.
Hey, it's my job to wrap up the episode, but there's not much I can add. Except perhaps the topic of the next episode. It's about how graphical programming enables basically every machine operator to make changes to the motion sequence on the factory floor. So stay tuned and catch you on the next one to be two steps ahead. Thank you.